afternoon dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. As you know that we are dealing with the practice 3.8 in which we are solving word problems based on multiplication and division. Okay, so in previous lecture we have seen first 5 word problems. In today's lecture we are going to solve remaining 5 word problems. So let's start with the problem number 6. A truck can carry 12,700 bags of cotton in one round. How many bags of cotton will it carry in 310 rounds? So see here in this problem, as you know that first we have to find what is given. First we have to find what is given, and the given is here. We can find the given in the first statement. A truck can carry 12,700 bags of cotton in one round. Okay, this is given. That is, cotton carried in one round. Cotton that can be carried in one round. It is given, right? So how much cotton? How much bags of cotton? Sorry, here it bags of cotton. Bags of cotton. So bags of cotton carried in one round, 12,700 bags. Fine. Now find the statement in which we have to find something. So this is the statement. How many bags of cotton will it carry in 310 rounds? So bags of cotton. That can be carried in 310 rounds. 310 rounds that we have to find. Okay, so here given for one round, given for one round, asking for 310 rounds. That is given for one, asking for many. And in this situation, what we have to do? Which operation we have to go for? Multiplication. Okay. So see, here we have to divide, multiply 12,700 into 310, fine. Okay, now see here, if you see these, both these numbers are multiple of 10 or 100. Here there are 2 zeros at the end, that means it is multiple of 100. Here there is 1 zero at the end, that means it is multiple of 10, okay. So in this case, what we do actually, you know, last zeros in both the numbers, in this number and this number, last zeros, count those zeros and write as it is down. See, here in the first number, at the end, there are 2 zeros, 1, 2, and here there is 1. So total, how many zeros are there at the end? 1, 2, and this one, 3. So those 3 zeros, write down. Okay, now remain this number, 127 into 31. 127 into 31. Multiply that. 1 7 is a 7. 1 2s are 2. 1 1s are 1. Put 0 at the 1's place. 3 7 is a 21. 2 will be carried. 3 2s are 6 and 2. 8. And 3 1s are 3. Okay. So 7 plus 0 7. 2 plus 1 3. 9 3. 3 9 3 7. That you have to write here. 127 into 31, 3937. So 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 1,10,000. That means what? So how many bags of cotton can be carried in 310 rounds? 39,37,000. Okay, 39,37,000. So 39,37,000 bags of cotton will be carried in 310 rounds. Okay, 310 rounds. Understood? So this way we have to solve. like this example. Let's move towards the example number 7. See, 2,91,46,565 brushes have to be packed in packets of 13 brushes each. Right, packets of 13 brushes each. How many complete packets can be made and how many brushes will be left behind? See this problem. See, this is the total number of brushes, that is 2,91,46,565. This much brushes are there, and those brushes we have to pack equally into the packets of 13 brushes. Means in each packet there must be 13 brushes. Understood? So if we divide like this, how many packets can be made, or how many complete packets can be made, and after packing completely some brushes will be left behind. Means there will be no complete 13 brushes, so that those brushes will be left behind. So how many those brushes that can be left? Okay, that we have to find. So two questions are there: how many packets can be made and how many brushes will be left behind. So as we have to divide the brushes into packets of 13, that means obviously which operation will be here? Division, correct? So let's divide. And how will when we divide these brushes by 13, whatever portion we will get, that will be number of packets. Okay, and after dividing, at the end some brushes will be left, that is remainder, correct? So whatever remainder we will get in this operation, that will be the number of brushes which we left behind. So let's divide first. First we'll write the details. What is given? Number of brushes. ₹2,91,46,565 brushes are there, and we have to find how many packets can be made if each packet is of 13 brushes. Number of packets made with 13 brushes in each. Okay, how many number of packets we have to find? So we have here question mark. So to find number of packets that can be made with the 13 brushes in each packet, we need to divide this by 13. So let's divide. Divide by 13. Now see here. 13, first we divide 29. 13 twos are 26, correct? 9 minus 6, 3. 2 minus 2, 0. Let's bring 1 down, became 31. Again, 31 are 13, 13 twos are 26, 13 threes are 39. But 39 is greater than 31. So smaller number is 13 twos are 26. So 1 minus 6 is not possible. We will take one borrow from this 3, so 3 will remain 2. Now 11 minus 6, 5, and 2 minus 2, 0. Let's bring next digit down, 54. 31 is 30, 32 is 26, 33 is 39, 13 4 is 52, correct? 13 4 is 52. So 4 minus 2, 2, 5 minus 5, 0. Let's bring 6 down, became 26. 32 is 26. Let's bring 5 down. Now there is 5, we have to divide it. So 13 zeros are 0. 5 minus 0, 5. Let's bring another digit 6 down. We get 56. 13 4 is 52, correct? See here, I don't have space, so the subtraction I am writing here. 6 minus 2, 4, and 5 minus 5, 0. Now next digit is 5. So I will write here 5. Now 13, 3 is a 39, 13, 4 is a 52. So this is 45, correct? That means we want smaller number than 45. So 13, 3 is a 39. Now see, 5 minus 9 not possible. So from 4, 1 will take borrow here, 5 will be written up, and 4 will remain 3. So 50 minus 9, 6, and 3 minus 3 is 0. So 6 is the remainder. Understood? So see here, when we divide it, 2,91,46,565 brushes into packet of 13 brushes each, how many packets are made? We have made 22,42,043 packets, complete packets, and 6 brushes are left behind. 6 brushes are left behind. So let's write the statement. So 22,42,043 complete packets can be made. And 6 brushes left behind. Understood? So this way we can solve these examples. If you have doubt in this, you can ask. Pause this video, write this in your notebook. We'll move towards the next questions. Let's solve the next question. Question number 8. See here. 4,37,33,760 bags of wheat have to be equally stored in 40 godowns. How many bags will be stored in each godown? See here. There are some number of bags of wheat. How many bags of wheat are there? For 4,37,33,760. Okay? And these bags we have to equally store in 40 godowns. There are 40 godowns. Godowns means what? Where we store grains. Okay? Like rice, wheat, and other. So number of bags of wheat are this much, and those this much bags we have to store equally into 40 godowns. Stored equally means distribute equally into 40 godowns, and equal distribution means nothing but division, correct? So we have to find bags in each of 40 godowns. Number of bags in each of 40 godowns when stored equally. Means these bags we are going to divide into 40 godowns equally. So how many bags will be each godown, that we have to find. Each of 40 godown. Okay. So here we have to do nothing but division, correct? So let us divide. Divide by. See here, divide by 40. Okay. Now see one trick I am going to tell you. This is divisor, this is dividend. At the end of this dividend and divisor, at the end of both these numbers, there is 0 if you notice. That 0 here, this 10 can be cut with this 10. If like this situation is there, if 10 is at the end of this and 10 is at the end of this, we can cut it. If there are 2 zeros at the end of both numbers, that also we can cut it. Okay. So see here, we got now this number and the divisor is 4. So let's divide by 4. 4 ones are 4, correct? 4 minus 4, 0. Let's take 3 down. 3 is smaller than 4, but we have to divide it. That means we will divide by 0. So 4 zeros are 0. 3 minus 0, 3. Let's bring 7 down. Became 37. 4 nines are 36, correct? 4 9s are 36. Smaller number than 37 is 36 in the table of 4. So 4 9s are 36. 7 minus 6 1 and 3 minus 3 0. So you will come down. Became 13. So 13 is not there in the table of 4. Then which number is less than 13 in the table of 4? 4 3s are 12. Correct? So 4 3s are 4 3s are 12. 3 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Again, let's bring 3 down. Became 13 again. Same, 4 3s are 12. So 3 minus 2, 1 and here 0. Let's bring 7 down. Became 17. Again, 17 is not there in table of 4. Then smaller number than 17 in table of 4 is 16. 4 4s are 16. 4 4s are 16. 7 minus 6, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Let's bring this 6 down. 1 and 6. Okay. So again, 4 4s are 16. 0, 0. So whatever quotient we have got, that is the number of bags that can be stored in each of 40 godowns. So how many? 1 crore 9 lakh 30 10 lakh 93,344. 10 lakh 93,344 bags of wheat can be stored in each ground, will be stored in each godown, not ground, godown. Understood? Let's solve the example number 10. See, the after 8 directly I have taken 10. 9th one example you have to solve by yourself. It's quite easy. Let's solve the 10th one example. See here, 1 crore 13,85,738 pencils are to be packed in packets containing 125 pencils each. How many such complete packets can be packed? So again, same question like 7th one. See, this much pencils are there. 1 crore 13,85,738. So those pencils or this much pencils we have to store in 125 packet of 125 pencils. That means in each packet there will be 125 pencils. So such how many complete packets can be made? How many complete packets can be made? That we have to find. Same example. First given number of pencils. How many number of pencils are there? 1 crore 13 lakh 85,738. This much pencils are there. And number of packets can be made. NO means number. Can be made with 125 pencils in each. In each. Means in each packet there will be 125 pencils. Such how many packets can be made? That we have to find. So this is nothing but what these pencils we have to divide equally. We have to make group of 125 pencils. Correct? So making equal group means what? Nothing but division. So we have to divide this by 125. Now see here, 1 crore 30 lakh 85,000 738 divided by 125. Okay. Now here we don't know table of 125, so we have to form here table of 125. Let's form 1, 2, 5. Okay. Let's write first table of 5. 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3 15 20 25 30 35 40 45 and 50. Develop 2. 2 2 is 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Develop 1. 1 and 1, 1 2 is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay. Now put equal sign in front of each. Now addition, okay. So ones place digit and add in the ones place in table of 5, digit in the ones place right here first. 5 will come as it is here. 0, this 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 0. Now whatever these tens place digits are there, that will be carried. While writing this, here 2 and here no carry, so 2 will come as it is. 4 plus 1, 5, 6 plus 1, 7, 8 plus 2, 10. Now see 8 plus 2, 10. So 0 will come down, 1 will be carried. Here I am writing 1. This 1 will be added later. 10 plus 2, 12. 2 will come down, 1 will be carried. 12 plus 3, 15. 5 will come, 1 will be carried. 14 plus 3, 17. 7 will come, 1 will be carried. 16 plus 4, 20. Correct? So 0 will come down, 2 will be carried. 18 plus 4, 22. 2 will come, 2 will be carried. 20 plus 5, 5, 25. So 5 will come, 2 will be carried. This 1 as it is, 2, 3, 4 plus carry 1, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. 7 plus 1, 8. 8 plus 2, 10. 9 plus 2, 11. And 10 plus 2, 12. So here we have table of 125. Fine, let's divide. First see, there is a 3 digit number. If you see, there is 113. 113 is less than 125. So let's think about 4 digit number. 1138. So is there 1138 in table of 125? No, there is. 1138 is not there in the table of 125. So smaller number than 1138 in the table of 125 is, yes, 1125. Understood? So 125 nines are, 1125 nines are 1125. So let's subtract it. 8 minus 5, 3. 3 minus 2, 1, 0, 0. Let's bring this down. 5, it became 135. Now 125, 1 is 125, 125, 2 is 250. Correct? So which number you take? 1 is, correct? 125, 1 is 125. 5 minus 5, 0. 3 minus 2, 1, 0. Let's bring next 7 down. Now there is 107 and we have to divide it by 125. Can we divide it? It is smaller than 125, correct? So we will save a table of 125 till 0. 125 zeros are 0. So 107 minus 0, that number itself. 0 minus any number is that number itself. Okay. Let's bring next digit down. 1073. So 1073 we have to divide it by 125, but 1073 is not there in the table of 125. The smaller number than 1073 in the table of 125 is, see, 1000, correct? 125 is a 1000. 3 minus 0, 3. 7 minus 0, 7. 0, 0. Let's bring 8 down. See here, 738. Okay, now again 738 is not there in the table of 125, but smaller number than 738 is 625 and next is 750. So we will take 625. Understood? 625 is smaller than 738. So 625 means 5 are 1 2 3 4 5. 5 are 625. 8 minus 5 3. 3 minus 2 1 and 6 7 minus 6 1. 113 is remainder. So how many complete bags can be made? Complete packets can be made? 91,085. So 91,085 complete packets can be made. They have not asked how many pencils will left. If they would have asked like this, how many pencils will be left? Then 113 pencils will be left. Can be made. Understood? So this way we have completed our practice 3.8. If you have any doubt regarding in this, you can ask. 9th one problem you have to solve as a homework. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.